You know, one of the perils of doing a weekly program is that nowadays so much happens in a week. And it's been about a week by the time you hear this since we launched airstrikes for the second time during Trump's presidency against Syria. We are going to be talking about those airstrikes and our general attitude toward the military in this hour with former Colonel Andrew Basevich, military historian and historian of American history as well. In this hour and throughout this program, I am going to be asking certain questions about our military intervention that don't seem to have been answered. They weren't answered before we attacked. They haven't been answered since. Among those questions, for example, why was it so important to attack on Friday, which is when the missiles were launched, when chemical weapons inspectors were arriving on Saturday? Why didn't we want to wait and find out exactly what happened, where, when, and to whom before intervening? And also, here's a thought for you. How many American people do you think, how many voters, how many members of our society understand how much we're already doing in Syria? As we talk about, we can't sit by and do nothing. That's a refrain I've heard over and over again. How many people realize how much we're actually doing? For example, how many people read the news, watched CNN, did everything they were supposed to do to keep themselves informed about the Syria attack, and yet didn't know, because it wasn't mentioned, didn't know that we have 2,000 ground troops in Syria? You know, a lot of people are just not aware of that fact, or that many of those ground troops are within embankment range, for example, of Russian troops and of Turkish troops who are actually members of NATO, as are we. So why is it that we keep hearing complaints that if we don't launch missiles and do it today, we will be guilty of inaction in Syria? There are many things we are doing in Syria, but inaction is not one of them. Not when you have 2,000 troops on the ground there, involved in military activities. So as we go forward, we will be asking more questions in this program. I hope you will stick around.